I thought it would be Sagat, but it turns out it's Sakura who's going to be the first character announced for Season 3 of Street Fighter V, judging by the major hint given by Capcom during Red Bull Battlegrounds. The moment I saw that, I couldn't help but remember a comment from a subscriber called Saki Tsuzuda, who wanted to see a list of fighting game schoolgirls. Well, I'll be damned, isn't this the perfect timing to do so? But first, a few ground rules. As it's probably pretty obvious, Japanese schoolgirls are extremely common in anime fighters, with some even composed entirely of them, so there's no way I can mention every single one. Therefore, I'll be limiting this list to only one character per franchise. In fact, you shouldn't even expect to see all your favorite anime fighters here, because, you know, I want to be a little more inclusive and not just spend the whole video in one subgenre. Maybe if I eventually make sequels there will be time for that, but for now, I'll try to be a little less obvious. With that said, let us start by taking a closer look at, who else? Sakura Kasugano from Street Fighter. Originally from Street Fighter Zero 2, or Alpha 2 in the West, Sakura has also appeared in Rival Schools, a Capcom franchise that I keep mentioning all the time, where she's seen hanging around with Hinata, Natsu, and Shoma. She's a very energetic and happy girl, with a positive attitude, extremely hardworking and focused in combat. She's Ryu's number one fan, always watching him fight and mirroring herself on his philosophies in battle. The white headband she wears all the time was given to her by Ryu before the events of Alpha 2. Rather than an opponent, Sakura sees him as an idol and a teacher, even though officially she's Dan Hibiki's student. Not really though, but she's too nice to tell him that. Another important relationship is her friendly rivalry with Karin Kanzuki, who appeared for the first time in the pages of Sakura's own manga series, Sakura Ganbaru, written and illustrated by Masahiko Nakahira. Quickly rising to be one of the most popular characters of the franchise, especially in Japan, Sakura has appeared in many different titles, including crossovers like Marvel vs. Capcom 2 and even the RPG styled Capcom Cross Namco. In terms of gameplay, she fights using an emulated, and thus comparatively weaker, version of Ryu's fighting style. Her moveset contains many unorthodox variations of existing Shotokan moves, including a running Shoryuken, a jumping Tatsumaki, and a less powerful Hadouken that she can charge, though at the cost of distance. Her moves and combos have high potential to stun opponents and also provide opportunities for mix-ups. However, her somewhat low stamina and her lack of other available approaches, particularly her weak projectile, require a certain amount of finesse, leaving little room for error. This ultimately makes Sakura a high-risk, high-reward character. Her combo-heavy playstyle, when supplemented by her normals and specials, make her a devastating fighter once she gets an opening. On a final note, just as a fun fact, Sakura is a rare Street Fighter character with a vocal theme song. I just want you to know, Kono Omoi o Tsutaetai, sung by Yuko Sasamoto, her first voice actress. It is first found in the arranged soundtrack of Super Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo. Next up, I'm going to provide a little fan service and, in name of the subscriber that suggested this topic, talk about Saki Tsuzuda from Arcana Heart. Since this isn't such a well-known game as Street Fighter, a little history lesson. Arcana Heart is a 2D arcade fighting game series developed by Eximo Inc., formerly Yuki Enterprise, and published by many different studios like Arc System Works and Atlas. The first edition was released to arcades, mostly in Japan, in late 2006, featuring an original all-female cast. After choosing a character, the player chooses an Elemental Alignment, or Arcana, which determines the character's special moves. As you might have guessed, this is one of those games that could easily fill the whole video since there's plenty of schoolgirls to choose from. Saki is a very impressive girl, both with her talents and skill, along with her studies. She is very mature and comes off as perfect to some, with a sophistication that cannot be matched. Her sense of duty is strong and she will take as much work as she can, even if it's more than she can bear. However, Saki has become cold and distant as a result and tends to keep people at arm's length. After the friend she made when living in Great Britain, Fiona Mayfield, was trapped in the elemental world, from where Saki was able to escape with the help of her newly acquired Arcana, her social skills took a major blow and she struggled to talk or open up to almost anyone. When she hears that her close friend, Heart, is going to investigate strange occurrences within the sky, Saki decides to stop her, afraid to lose someone else to the elemental world. As for her in-game persona, Saki Tsuzura is known throughout the series for her iconic fantastic flash kick and her overhead dive kick. She's also the charge character of the series, with charge motions you probably didn't even know existed, like charging up or forward. She's a solid, well-rounded character whose biggest weakness is her inability to win by simply pressing good buttons. And if you can't be bothered with choosing the best character or Arcana combinations, you'll be pleased to know that Saki has no large weaknesses that must be covered, thus allowing pretty much any Arcana to work with her. Love, however, seems to be her most popular choice. On to the next character now. This time we'll be talking about a schoolgirl from the King of Fighters series, Hinako Shijo. Wait, I know what you're thinking. What the hell, man? Why not Athena Asamiya? Well, you're right, Athena is by far the most popular schoolgirl of the series, maybe even one of the most popular in fighting games. But there's one little detail about Hinako that I find absolutely amusing and unique. Her fighting style of choice is sumo. Yes, sumo, like E. Honda, Gangryu, or Takarashi. I'm sorry, but I just couldn't miss the chance to talk about her. If there's ever a sequel, I promise I'll find a place for Athena there. But for now, Hinako. She grew up to value sumo's techniques after watching a professional match and, hoping to practice along with her classmates, tried to create a female sumo club at her school, an idea that failed miserably. After a while, she heard about the women team auditioning for a member and succeeded to prove her worth, joining their squad until the King of Fighters 2003, where, along with Athena and Malin, she formed the high school girl team. Despite her small build, Hinako is really strong and uses hard-hitting sumo attacks, being able to whip out a ton of damage in no time. It's a strange entry in the world of fighting game schoolgirls, but if you like surprising your opponents with a fight they will not be prepared for, maybe Hinako is just what you need. But if you're looking for someone a little more conventional, perhaps I can interest you in Chia Satanaka from Persona 4 Arena. Chia is an upbeat, cheerful, and energetic tomboy who first appeared in the turn-based RPG Persona 4, and later joined the roster of the series' fighting game title, Persona 4 Arena. Although she has a short temper, Chia is, in reality, an extremely protective person, especially when it comes to her best friend, Yukiko Amagi. She's also a huge fan of steak and kung fu movies, often bringing them up in normal conversations or going so far as to spontaneously yell out battle cries. Her fighting style is called Greaves, which is a self-taught Jeet Kune Do, with her deadly kicks being her most feared weapon. She is an aggressive, rushdown heavy character that uses her speed and pressure tools to overwhelm her opponent's defenses by never giving them a chance to retaliate. She also has very high damage potential, starting from just about any starter, consistently hit-confirming into combos from most hits with a strong emphasis on strong and fast block strings. Her all-out attack is arguably one of the best in the game, as it's fast, has good range, and causes a knockdown on an airborne opponent. True to her archetype, however, Chia has short range on many of her attacks, coupled with a mediocre defensive skill set. And if schoolgirls with kung fu skills is your thing, I have time for one more entry in this list, Lin Xiaoyu from Tekken. Though she has never worn a Seifuku as her default costume, it doesn't take much to unlock a schoolgirl uniform for Lin Xiaoyu, which also tends to be heavily featured in her cutscenes. She is, by heart, a schoolgirl, even if she doesn't really dress as one for every fight. Xiaoyu was first introduced in Tekken 3 as a 16-year-old girl and has returned in every subsequent release. Her fighting style was brought on with some influences from her master, Wang Jingrei, a character that she sort of replaced in the roster. Her main goal throughout most of the series is to, through fighting in the tournaments, earn enough money to build her own amusement or theme park. However, in subsequent games of the series, Shoyu became more focused on the Mishima family's issues, in particular those of Jin Kazama, who she even pairs with in Street Fighter Cross Tekken. Despite missing the first two games of the series, by this point Shoyu is one of the most popular characters in the Namco franchise, having appeared in many other projects like crossover games or movie adaptations. In Tekken Blood Vengeance, for example, she's even casted in a starting role, having been recruited by Anna Williams to spy on Shin Kamiya. Oddly enough, her ending in some of the games combine a mix of anime-like animation and CGI, which is quite unique in the series. With her personal story being increasingly connected to the central plot of the franchise, Xiaoyu has established relationships with some of its key players, like her secret crush, Jin Kazama, and sort of tutor Heihachi Mishima that, impressed with her skills, took her to Japan and even trained a security guard to protect her. who happens to be a panda, but that's beside the point. If you're more interested in the gameplay aspects, Ling Shouyu is an offensive poking character with unique stances and movement options that allow for lots of mix-ups, tricky maneuvering and crushing. She's an Okizeme monster, which, if you're not familiar, is a term in fighting games that means pressuring the opponent while they are getting up after being knocked down. Although Okizeme has been nerfed in the recent Tekken 7, Ling still retains that aspect of her character. She has a strong poking game with tons of poke lows for various situations, including hugely frame-positive hits, a ranged counter-hit launcher, and a heavy-hitting low in her stance. Her stance, Art of Phoenix, allows her to evade a lot of moves and offense from her opponent, reducing their moveset by a lot depending on the character. Her small hitbox, along with her evasive stances, can make her extremely hard to approach, especially with her main mid-poke going under highs. But these techniques might require some training to really get it right. She does, however, have poor reach on her jabs as her limbs are short, meaning she can struggle to punish certain moves. She also might have difficulty getting damage whenever her trickier stuff falls flat, and some of her best options in her stances can be beaten by stepping. Overall, Ling can be a powerful character if you're willing to take the time to practice enough with her to be able to come up with the nastiest, trickiest setups. So that's about all the time we have for Schoolgirl Fighters for now. Let us know in the comments your favorites and they might get added to the list in a possible sequel. Also, how excited are you about Sakura's return to Street Fighter? Is she the first character you would like to see announced for Season 3, or, like me, you would prefer to hear about Sagat? As usual, please leave a like if you enjoyed the video and try to share this with a couple of friends. This has been Edu, the Kami Player, and I'll talk to you guys later. P.S. This has nothing to do with the topic at hand, but Venom was just announced for Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, and I have something to say about that. What the f*** is that voice, Capcom? Are you crazy? Has anyone listened to it before releasing? This is awful. It might be the worst voiceover in a fighting game character ever. It's ridiculous. I absolutely refuse to play Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite until someone fixes this horrible voice. Perhaps there will be a much needed mod for that. Let us pray there will be one.